Hello dear friends, myself Professor Kodide Rishikesh, and here we are discussing about the nitrogen metabolism in channel BSc Botany Studies classes. This is the final part of nitrogen metabolism. In previous part we have discussed many aspects of nitrogen metabolism. You can check those videos in SYBSc playlist. So let's get started. In today's lecture we are going to discuss about mainly the nitrification. Denitrification, ammonification, after that we will be discussing about reductive amination and transamination. So whatever I have written on the board we are going to discuss in a detail. So let's go step by step manner. First of all, you are very much aware about the nitrogen in atmosphere, which is present in the form of gas. The nitrogen molecule contain two nitrogen atom. This nitrogen is present in 78% in atmosphere. But this nitrogen is useless to the plant directly. For that it need to be converted into useful forms. So the useful form are converted with the help of nitrogen fixation. We already have discussed. In a detail, what is nitrogen fixation? So the after nitrogen fixation, the useful compound can be produced, which can be used by the plants. So it was regarding nitrogen fixation on which we have discussed many more points in previous lectures. So what happen actually is that when animal or plant dies by natural death or by accidental death, that animal or plant contain nitrogen containing organic compound inside them. For example, many proteins, many nucleotides contain this nitrogen inside the molecule. This nitrogen has to get free so that other growing organism can utilize them. If organism dies after death of organism, the decomposition process starts to take place. So decomposition process mainly involve conversion of complex molecule into the simple molecules. Complex molecules such as proteins, nucleotides need to be converted into simple form. The nitrogen containing compound are simplified and ammonia created, or ammonium ion is created. Ammonia and ammonium ion, there is difference of charge. This is an ion, this is just ammonia, are created. The process in which this happens, this process is called as ammonification. So it is very easy to understand what is ammonification. The nitrogen fixation was different, ammonification is different. What happens in ammonification is that the complex compound in organism after their death, or after their secretion or excretion, we can say the excretory products, or after death of the organism or animal or plant, these complex compound are converted into the simple ammonia form, so that this ammonia can be utilized by other organism. So it is sort of cycle. So the point is which are given are indicating that the nitrogen cycle has to happen, because 78% nitrogen in atmosphere has to recycle back into the atmosphere. So remember, this ammonification involves formation of ammonia or ammonium ion from dead organism or from the excreta of the living organism. Okay, it was the ammonification stage. So nitrification is another step which is included in syllabus. What is this nitrification? The nitrification process involves the conversion of this ammonia or the molecule from the living organism into the nitrate or nitrite form. this nitrate or nitrite form creation process is known as nitrification. So it will be very easy to understand what is nitrification and what is difference in ammonification. It was ammonification. This is nitrification. After ammonification or nitrification, it is essential to release the nitrogen which is present in this compound in back into the atmosphere. So there are several bacteria who do this job. They release the nitrogen which are present in such compounds back into the atmosphere. These processes are known as denitrification. The processes are known as denitrification. So nitrogen fixation is there, ammonification is there, nitrification is there, and denitrification is there. All these processes shows the nitrogen cycle which takes place in an environment. So it is very essential process. It has to take place in order to continuation of life on this planet. Because nitrogen is something which is present in 78% has to get recycled. Not only nitrogen, there are carbon cycle, water cycle are also there. So you must have understood there are various enzymes who are playing the role in all these processes. There are some bacteria who are involved in nitrification because they contain special type of enzyme who do this job. There are different bacteria who perform nitrification because they contain different enzymes for nitrification process. There are several bacteria who convert this nitrite form into the free nitrogen, which is atmospheric nitrogen. This process involves steps. I have just highlighted the differences between these terminologies. So let's discuss in further points in this chapter. So friends, on the board I have written two different steps or two different types of reaction, where one says reductive amination and another is a transamination type of reaction. So what is difference between them? It is very essential to know for students. The reductive amination is the process in which first amino acid formation takes place. Please remember this, try to write down these points. The reductive amination involves formation of first amino acid, and transamination involves formation of different amino acids. So reductive amination, in which we will find the first amino acid synthesis has been takes place, where transamination involves the formation of many different amino acids takes place. Actually there are 20 amino acids are required for proper protein development. In any organism there are listed 20 amino acids are required. Here first amino acid synthesis takes place, that is reductive amination, and here transamination takes place, where different amino acids are synthesis takes place. Different means different 19 amino acid synthesis we can say takes place, and here one amino acid synthesis. Which one amino acid? It is very important. The first amino acid is a glutamate. Please remember this word. The first amino acid is known as glutamate amino acid, which is synthesized in the process of reductive amination. The reductive amination, if you try to write the reaction for reductive amination, you will find, if you have ammonia group available, the ammonia may be available by ammonification process or by nitrogen fixation process, doesn't matter. This ammonia, if available, then it will react with alpha keto. Glutarate. The alpha keto glutarate is 5 carbon compound, and I am sure you must have heard the name of this compound somewhere in Krebs cycle. In Krebs cycle, you will have malate, alpha keto glutarate, succinate, oxaloacetate. These are carbon containing compound. Alpha keto glutarate is 5 carbon containing compound which already contain one amino group. Okay, so after getting additional amino group, it converted into the glutamate. by the enzyme glutamate synthase. There is a very huge biochemical pathway involved here. I have just written in one line the Gogut pathway. Gogut pathway is involved for synthesis of first amino acid, that is glutamate amino acid. This glutamate amino acid generally work as a carrier of amino group, because the free ammonia is not retained inside the cell as it is, because this ammonia may cause toxicity to that cell. Ammonia is responsible for toxicity of cell. If it remains free, it should not remain free. For that, reductive amination takes place. You are adding ammonia on the alpha ketoglutarate. That's why they have given the name reductive. And you are talking about ammonia. That's why reductive amination process name has been given. The amino acid is produced is known as glutamate amino acid. This glutamate amino acid is ready now. It is the first amino acid which is prepared by the process of reductive amination. This glutamate is very intelligent. This glutamate, after getting react with oxaloacetate, this oxaloacetate you must have heard in Krebs cycle, this is 4-carbon compound. This glutamate donates the amino group to the alpha ketoglutarate and result into the formation of aspartate, and alpha ketoglutarate. So it is easy to remember why alpha ketoglutarate is there, because it is losing their amino group and oxaloacetate is converted into the aspartate. So all these amino acid cycles are attached to the Krebs cycle. That's why it is sometimes called as a bicycle. Bicycle contains two wheels. So amino acid synthesis is one wheel, or nitrogen metabolism you can say is one wheel, whereas the Krebs cycle is another wheel of the cycle. So we have discussed here about the differences between reductive amination and transamination in just a brief fashion. So there are different amino acid can be prepared. Sometimes it is noticed that another amino acid is also prepared in a reductive amination, that is proline amino acid, but it will create complication in understanding. That's why I have kept it up to the glutamate amino acid only. Just remember, the first amino acid is synthesized in reductive amination. In transamination, different types of amino acid are prepared. Actually, in cell you will find there are more than 200 amino acids are there. Different types of 200 amino acids are there. Only 20 amino acids out of these 200 amino acids are utilized for proper protein development. So first amino acid development takes place by reductive amination, whereas other amino acid synthesis takes place by transamination. It is just a game of transferring of amino group. So generally the enzyme involved in this process are belonging to the transferase category of enzyme. So this transferase enzyme transfer one group from one group to the another group. So these enzymes play critical role in all these processes. So it was the end of chapter of nitrogen metabolism. I hope you must have understood critical thing. Some videos you need to see twice to understand the concept. So don't forget to subscribe the channel. We will meet in next chapter with next concept and new ideas. So thank you for your time. Bye.